Hi there, how's it going?
All right. Have you ever heard of iceworms?
Iceworms? No. I need more walk arounds. Now, iceworm, what is this? I've got to find out.
An iceworm? Sure, I've seen iceworms.
Where you seen them?
In the iceberg. In your glass of soda pop. Where else besides the glaciers?
How about you? Have you ever seen an iceworm?
No, I haven't been around too much.
Never heard of an iceworm.
You believe in iceworms?
What are iceworms?
What if I told you they lived in the ice?
Yeah, I'd believe that.
I have one. But it's not real. It's kind of flat and fuzzy, and you take your finger like this, and it goes up and down. Let's do that.
Iceworm?
Iceworm? No, I've never heard of an iceworm.
You think there's something that might exist?
There very well could be.
I think they're pretty elusive, but I think, wait a minute, they're in Antarctica, I believe. And they're very elusive, they're hard to find, you know, because they can hear your footsteps and then they just crawl deeper. You have to dig really fast in order to catch them. But that's all I've ever heard about. Iceworms.
Do you believe in iceworms?
Do I believe in yes, I believe in iceworms. Yes.
You know they actually exist?
I've seen them. Portage Glacier's full of them. In fact, that's where the tourists go over there, isn't it? To see all the iceworms.
Alaska Review traveled 40 miles south of Anchorage to Portage Glacier. We wound our way up to Byron Glacier, a companion of Portage's, to hunt for the elusive iceworm.
We're looking for iceworm, Mesenchytraeus solifugus. And solifugus means son of oiter.
Leading this iceworm safari is National Park Service naturalist Chris Degernes.
I guess Alaska's full of skeptics. Most Alaskans, longtime Alaskans, and newcomers disbelieve the fact that iceworms do exist. And they've heard the Robert Service poem, the Ballad of the Iceworm Cocktail, and they've heard about Cordova's Iceworm Festival, and they've probably seen the little iceworms sold, fake iceworms sold in gift stores. So they don't really believe us, and I think this is kind of a snipe hunt, and it's a lot to make them come out here and hike this mile to get here to look for them, but they come here just to see if they really do exist. I'll give you all a vial here and a toothpick, and the vial has alcohol in it to preserve them. Might just find a few down below, but the farther up we go, we should be getting into some better areas. So,
they move pretty fast.
First prize at the first ice room. So, let's go see if we can find them. I guess one of the best things about this area is that this is one glacier that's easily accessible, safe to walk on, and just downright easy to get to find iceworms and where we can usually find them. So it's probably one of the easiest areas around here to go out and find the iceworm, just like this. Only a mile hike, pretty level ground, and we aren't really even on the glacier as such right here. We're pretty much just on the snow right at the edge of the glacier, and so it's safe just as long as an avalanche doesn't fall down. Iceworms are related to earthworms and leeches, and as such they breed like earthworms. Each iceworm is made up of two sexes, both sexes in the same worm, but it still takes two. They lay eggs, the eggs hatch into young worms, and a lot of these real small worms that we're seeing today are probably this year's hatch of iceworms.
I thought it was a joke, really, but it came up here and this girl, a ranger, told him about it this afternoon when we decided that we would go iceworm fishing, and then here they are. Here's one buried down in the ice right here. See that? See, that looks like an iceworm there. It is. See it? See it moving? but this is quite an experience. I always thought it was kind of a hoax. It's for real. You can see the worms. I've gotten them.
What's the biggest ice worm you've ever seen?
Oh, I don't know, maybe about an inch and a half long. Trophy size. I might add that in this particular area, we probably are recommending a bag limit of these things, because we're expecting probably a mad rush after this of ice worm hunters. And if everybody comes and gets their million ice worms, we'll probably run out. So probably, say, 6 to 10 ice worms per person would probably be a pretty good number. Because if you get too many in that vial, all you're going to see is just a mass of worms, and you won't really see the individual worms. So just have a few in the vial, and it makes it much nicer, too, to display. There's a lot of research on ice worms, but yet there still isn't that much known about them. I guess every living thing has a purpose. They have their little niche. They feed on pollen and algae, and birds feed on them. And it's just another living being that's probably one of the unique, most unique beings, because it's adapted to an environment where nothing else is adapted. It's just found its own little niche. And that's the cold, stressful glacier environment. They're able to live right in the glacier ice as well as the snow where we're finding them now. So, remember when you're cramponing up some coastal glacier that you tread not on a lifeless chunk of ice, but rather a harsh environment that some remarkable creature calls home.